Evening folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome to our final build episode of Blackrock Park. Yes, this is the very last thing we have to do. We're going to finish off the Blackrock Science Center. We're going to add tons of lights, and the first thing we're going to do, probably the most exciting thing we're going to do, is we're going to build ourselves a little aquarium right here in the middle. We're going to fill this glass case with water. We're going to make some fake jellyfish, and we're just going to try to make an aquarium as much as we can. Big credit, I've seen a few people do this now, but a big credit to Aurora, who posted a piece on the Steam Workshop, you know, months ago now. Actually, I highlighted it a very, very long time ago. I think in week two of my highlight videos when I was doing those. And just big credit to them. I'm sure other people have done it. I don't know if Aurora was the first, but they were the first person I saw to do it. So, you know, big shout out to them for the idea in the first place, which I love. I think it's a genius idea and it's really cool. And you'll see it happen in this video. So just building the aquarium, changing the floor to rock, just want no semblance of grass there. I think it's important to have some rocks in here just in order to, you know, have the plants hanging off something and make it look more like a real aquarium, I guess. It's kind of hard to fill them on. Actually, as you can see right here, there's really very few, and this is me checking her build to see how she did it, and hers is better than mine. I'll say that right now. Her build is definitely better than mine. I don't want to assume. I actually thought I caught that out. What was I saying? I can't remember. Anyways, there's actually no aquatic plants, which is what I was confused about. Like, there's very, very few aquatic plants in the game, just because we don't have aquariums, we don't have fish, we don't have water-based creatures, generally speaking. So, why would they add aquatic plants? It'd be nice to get some coral and stuff like that, maybe down the line, but we'll see what happens. So really, it's just using other plants, other regular plants, mainly tropical is what I'm going to use, to build the impression of an aquarium, I guess. This stuff, the Alpine Current, is amazing because it basically looks like seaweed. It really does look immensely like seaweed. So I'm going to cover the floor in a lot of that stuff. And then I'm going to put in some cacti. I know that seems nonsense, but they do kind of look like sea urchins a little bit, which I think is the idea. I think that's a pretty good idea as well. This stuff, what's this? Bramble bush. Again, kind of looks like seaweed. I want it kind of growing all over the rocks. The idea being, as per usual, it's like a slice of the real ocean. These rocks have been here for thousands of years, and the ocean's kind of growing above them and stuff like that. I don't know what I'm about, but you know what I mean. There is a lack of colour, it must be said. Everything that looks oceany kind of looks green, because everything else is a flower, and I don't think the flowers suit that much. We get a little burst with these lobster claws, stuff like this. You just need stuff that kind of looks like it's going upwards. A lot of flowers, yeah, you'll see what I mean, I think. Nettles, again, pretty good. Facsimile for seaweed, pretty close. Not half bad. It does come together at the end, I promise. Everything always comes together at the end. Papyrus sedge, which I still hate from the bottom of my heart. And this stuff's pretty good. The elephant eel plants, they work pretty well. Just anything that looks like it could possibly exist underwater. I was very close to putting those in. I can't remember what they're called. Very, very close. But the way they kind of point downwards, I think, doesn't really make sense in the ocean, because the ocean, things float in the ocean, right? Plant life floats. Everything floats upwards, essentially. So if you've got a plant that points directly down, like those do, I don't think that makes a lot of sense. It's like seaweed. Seaweed points straight up, because obviously things float. Anyways, we have to build some jellyfish. It's super easy. It really is. We're using the same method Aurora does. It's primitive prolate halves. Also some just semicircle halves as well. Semi-spheres. Spheres gone half. Yeah, those things right there. And you stick a few of those in. I'm going to stick to roughly the same colours. There's two different colours there, although it's hard to tell. Just the idea being they're the same species, you know. It's not meant to be 10 different multicoloured jellyfish. I'm trying to keep it, you know, logical-ish. And then use vines. It'd be nice if you could colour the vines and stuff like that. That'd be pretty cool, but just vines. Yeah, just stick them in. And don't do what I'll do in a second, which is have them all float behind the jellyfish. You'll see it in a sec. I think I'm putting them in there, in the spheres. I think it's perfect, and then rotate the camera around and realize, oh, they're all sticking out at bizarre angles. Some of them aren't even inside the spheres, the prolates, whatever they are. Well, some are spheres, some are half spheres. Prolate? Prolate? Isn't prolate like an alien species or something? Anyways, did some copying for some of them. Man, that's it. That's all it takes to make a jellyfish. Really simple. This is a really cool idea. Now, I cannot for the life of me remember who came up with this idea, and I'm super sorry because it's awesome. I'm going to mention this later on as well. But the idea is basically to use the blossom petal special effect. You put it in your trees and it looks like blossom petals are falling down. You put that in, and if you put it in the right place, it kind of looks like a little fish swimming around. It just like brings like a little life to the whole thing. It's actually really, really cool. You'll see it later on. It's a good idea. I'm very impressed with the creativity people use that I then steal for my videos. So what we're going to do here is do our solar system, basically. I'm going to keep it fairly simple because it's, yeah, but there's the sun. And yeah, so we're only going to use three different sizes of planets. Four if you include the sun itself. There's a little Pluto. I couldn't exclude Pluto. I know technically not a planet. Not one of the, you know, the big ones in our solar system, blah, 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 blah. But it's Pluto. It's adorable. The only one I have a problem with, Venus. Is it Venus? I think it's Venus. Because Venus comes in, I don't know, like, if you Google Venus, like, there's lots and lots and lots of different images of different colours. Now, I think it largely depends on what you use to take the imagery in the first place. I think with the naked eye, Venus is kind of like a pale yellow, so I will end up changing that later on, or like right now. I changed it a little bit. Yeah, there we go. Pale sort of yellowish colour. That's the best approximation I could find. Gonna make it so they're not floating. That makes a lot of sense. You know, we could make them float and it would be totally okay, but I really do want to try to approximate realism wherever possible, you know. As nonsensical as that might seem. Yeah, that's our planets. I'm gonna do a couple of little details on them, but I think they look pretty cool. Gonna bring this out a little bit. I wasn't really sure what to do here, really. I think I've committed too hard to the black plaster, but this ends up working out pretty well, so that's eventually gonna be where the signs are, just showing the names of the planets, basically. Get the rock to spread out a little further for reasons I can't quite remember. I'm sure there are some. I mean, it just looks better. It's too gradual. And as per usual, there's rocks sticking out of the back of the building, because there always bloody is. But that's okay. I've realised, by the way, I watch back my videos sometimes. Not often, because why would I? I do this a lot. Like, and I'm very conscious of it. And yet I keep doing it. I noticed I did it like 20 seconds ago. I'm going to try to stop. These are going to be our signposts. I nearly did it. I don't know what's wrong with me. What you can do with the signs like this is actually really cool. We're actually going to move them onto that bottom tilted bit. It ends up looking a little bit better. But what you can do, although it's hard to do if you grab them all, you have to do it one by one. You can sync them into the wall so that the text all but disappears. You'll see what I'm on about. Well, I mean, the sign itself disappears. The text is there. Now, with these ones, they've got like a little underline. I think that's just because of the angle nature. If you do it on a wall, you can get rid of it entirely. But it just looks like it's underlined the name. So I'm pretty okay with that as well. Wanted Earth to look like Earth, so I wasn't really sure what to do, if I'm totally honest, so I just sort of stuck some shapes in. It looks a little bit daft. Also, Saturn needs its telltale rings, right? That's what some other nonsense going on. Oh yeah, the wolves were getting sick because of the water. I forgot to put a water thingy in. Saturn, I did it again. Saturn needs its rings, obviously. I think I can go one bigger than this looking at this again. It looks a little daft. Obviously, the rings should not be directly connected to Saturn. They should be floating sort of off it somewhat. I might redo that. Going to put some stars in. This took an immensely long time. I got incredibly bored by the end of this. I'm not going to lie. It took ages. It's not fun. It's tedious, tedious, tedious work. Just like I mentioned with the plant life back in the wolf exhibit, you know, where I had the idea of kind of building this block of plants that you can sink into the ground to make like a varied, grassy, natural looking section. I kind of want to do that with this. Just build a block of stars that's kind of one block size, you know, one building block, like these building blocks here. And then you can duplicate it and you can rotate it and maybe change a couple here and there, and it would speed the process up quite a lot. I think that's a good idea. I'm going to start designing some blueprints to make my life a little easier, I think. I've got hiccups. What I really wanted to do was cheat here as well, so it does end up working somewhat. It takes a surprisingly long time. It was being really weird. I was just grabbing things. I wasn't sure what I was grabbing. It was like an orgy in a basement. Just wasn't sure what I was getting hold of at all. But it did eventually work, and the whole thing gets covered in stars, and it looks perfectly nice. Delete that little bit of glass out. I was grabbing the glass. Why was I grabbing the glass? No idea. So that's basically done. I think I realised that the whole thing's just looking a little bit too dark, and it didn't feel like people would naturally be able to walk around it in some ways, so I decided to just put some wooden pathing, matching the wooden pathing we already used from the outside, but just putting that inside, just like a random pathway. Still keeping the black on the outskirts, because that's kind of how I envisioned it in the first place, but just enough to make it seem like there's a pathing system at play, basically. And it looks fine. Not much to say on that one, it looks okay. The whole, I mean, we'll say, like, you're going to hear me fangirl about my own work later on. The whole thing ends up looking really cool. It's all lights and shiny and technical and futuristic. I'm really proud of it, I'm not going to lie. I did want to put, like, a little fence in there to block people from, like, stroking my planets. From stroking the balls. But, sorry, it's one of those days. I don't know what's wrong. It's a Sunday, give me a break. But I just couldn't think of anything, really. And it's fine. I think it's okay to have people walk up to it somewhat. And there's a little sign that we're going to put in anyway. Just saying, our solar system. And if people want to stroke the sign, they can do. I'm not here to limit what people can stroke. We live in a society. And so forth. There's a baby screaming outside. Anyways, same angle as that. Our solar system. There you go. Shush! What do you have to complain about? You're a baby. You have no troubles. Anyways, putting some pillars behind there. Just, again, because I like things to have some... Can you hear that? How can I hear no noises of the baby? I live in, like, the middle of the tourist district in London. Like, I should be able to hear all these noise. Yeah, all I hear is the baby. It's like the baby... Like, maybe everyone else on the planet has suddenly disappeared. And only the baby remains alive. Anyways, so again, I wanted to sink the signs into the wall. It doesn't really work against the rock because the rock is not perfectly flat. It's kind of flat, but it's not perfectly flat. So I decided to bring in the plaster once again. We will be changing the colour of that slightly. And we're basically going to do what we talked about, like an info board sort of thing for our animals, essentially. It ends up being nonsensical, but I had fun with it. Just for reference, by the way, I should say this whole build was about 2 hours, something like that, with about another 30 to 40 minutes work after this in the non-time-lapse section. So it was a fairly big build. And considering we'd already made the building and a lot of the work already, the whole thing was probably 4 or 5 hours. Anyways, here we go. We're going to do some text. In all honesty, basically copied it off Wikipedia, made up some nonsense on my own. I wasn't really going to go too much into detail on this, but it looks nice, you know. So, yeah, it's going to be some writing. That's me Googling right there. The Western Diamondback is a venomous rattlesnake species found in the southwestern United States and Mexico. It is a deadly... Sometimes I have to kind of change how much I was writing to make it fit. Deadly snake responsible for the majority of snake bite deaths in northern Mexico. Add more text. Don't tap the glass. To the right is the Gila monster. Oh, no, the venomous... Lizard, the Gila monster, from the same area as the Diamondback. This guy packs a dangerous concoction of venoms, but he's also lazy and so rarely a danger to humans like you and me, I assume. I wanted to have some fun with it. There's our little text board. We're going to do another one over here on hairy scorpions, which to the right hand side is our hairy scorpion. The larger scorpion in North Plantiora. Shut up, world. The larger scorpion... Shut, what are you doing? What are you revving? Why are you being a dick? This hairy scorpion is so large and aggressive that it can actually feed on lizards, snakes, and even other scorpions! Exclamation point. Thankfully, it's not deadly to humans, with a sting only as strong as that of a honeybee. Still, ouch! I kind of ran out of things to say here. At this point, I don't actually know what to say. Maybe lyrics from the song I was listening to, which was... Although his spirits are high, his blood counts... It upsets me every time. I'm going to talk about that later as well, so don't worry about it if you're curious. Put a few plants in here. I decided to, again, try to be logical and not put cacti in the open next to the display. Just because children would lick it or something, and that's nonsense. Right, the last thing we're going to build. I told you, it's a big build. Again, one of you recommended this, and again, I cannot remember. I should really write down names beforehand. I'm super sorry about this. I should also sit up instead of slouching like a nerd. Somebody recommended doing like the plants of Blackrock kind of thing. You know, that's because it's sciencey, it's botany, and it makes sense for Blackrock. You know, it's a natural kind of place. We should celebrate the plant life of Blackrock. And I thought that was a pretty cool idea, so that's what we're going to do. We've got these individual little chambers that we're going to fill in with a variety of different plants. Unfortunately, none of the trees fit. The cypress tree fits, but I was intent to try to fit some of the others, and yeah, it doesn't really work. That bad boy fits though. Holly tree. So these are all plants that we've used in the series. The holly tree is actually the one we've used the least out of all these, and I do replace it with something else. But everything else we're seeing here is stuff that I've used a lot throughout the park. So it's stuff that they'd recognize potentially from the exhibits, which again makes a lot of sense. Gonna put some wood on there. Kind of nice to bring the wood in again, block it off a little bit. And also I'm gonna turn that into an info board. I didn't really have any plans for this. It was funny. I just kind of made it up as I went along, and for once that worked. Usually that goes really badly. Bringing in the blue lights because I love my blue lights. What can I say? And they end up looking really cool. I don't know why I had to whisper that. ASMR Bob. That was me trying to say ASMR. ASMR. Bloody Nora. So, some blue lights. And we're going to do another signpost thing. The plants of Black Rock. And this, again, I'm going to write something here, and it's just, it's nonsense, okay? It's utter nonsense. Just roll with me here. but that's okay. I like my nonsense. Do end up putting some signs in. I was going to try to put them in there, but yeah. Ends up hanging on the roof. Also tried these ones, but I actually quite like those. I think they're really cool, and I'm excited to use those in the future, but they also don't really fit the theme of the science building, which doesn't quite have the rusticness of the rest of the park. Do end up replacing these signs as well. Yeah, it doesn't really have that rustic kind of quality that a lot of the rest of the park has. It's a science building, at the end of the day, it's meant to be very urgh and sciencey. So, decided against those. And also, I don't really like how they stretch the text down weirdly. Plants of Blackrock. Here we go. So this is what I mean. I'll talk about that later as well. It's hard to do this sometimes because there's things I'm going to talk about. I've already done the post time lapse recording. You know, of me actually just playing the game, not sped up. But now I'm recording the time lapse voiceover, and like, well, I've already said that. But what have I not said? Like, I need to like lists of what I can talk about in each video. This is the Metal Bear. The Metal Bear demands that you don't touch anything. Okay, Metal Bear is furious with you. It's kind of like Smokey the Bear, which I believe is an American thing about forest fires. Only you can prevent forest fires, all that kind of malarkey. Putting some info signs. Just because, why not, basically? Like, they're not going to turn on. They're not info panels about flowers, unfortunately. But, you know, they look like they make sense. And I thought the one for Blackrock would be a terrifying metal bear for some reason. I don't know why, but I decided that was a great idea. So it is. Blackrock Park is home to a huge variety of varied plant life, from the small but beautiful twin flower all the way up to the mighty yellow cedar. See, I'm just going to write nonsense. Cedar tree. We couldn't fit one in here, sorry, because we couldn't fit the yellow cedar in. The variety of flora doesn't only look good, but it fulfills a vital role in the natural wonder of Blackrock Park and its animal residents. The bisons, pronghorns couldn't survive without the natural bounty Blackrock provides for them. And of course, the wolves and bears wouldn't do very well without the food provided by the bison and pronghorns! Exclamation point. Blackrock then becomes a self-maintaining ecosystem, wherein bears and wolves keep the bison and pronghorn populations in check, eventually, and they in turn keep the natural flora nicely balanced. There you go, the plants of Blackrock. It's nonsense. And then I wanted to move the whole thing down, and it's nearly impossible to do, so I decided against it. We are near the end, folks. A minute left-ish. Can't remember what I'm going to do. Yes. No, I'm going to thicken up this just because I want it to be, the path to be the same distance from the aquarium on both sides. Also going to add some of those blue, a little trellis here with small black rock plants because that blank wall was annoying me. The blank wall behind the bears annoying me as well. Don't know what I'm going to do about that. I'll have to have a little think. Everyone's so loud today. It's a bad day. Although this went really well, like so I'm kind of happy. Decided to swap the holly tree, because we don't really use the holly tree for the Guelder Rosebush, because the Guelder Rosebush is my like one of my favourites, and we use it all the time. Gonna bring the blue in, do I do it now? Yeah, gonna bring the blue in at the bottom of the aquarium. I was really unsure about this, bearing in mind I have not seen any of this at night time. I have no idea what any of it looks like, so it was all kind of a guess on my part that it would look cool. And it does look cool. It looks awesome. Yeah, only 10 seconds left. This is basically the last thing we do. And then what we're going to do in the non-time lapse is fill in the aquarium, we're going to fill in with the water, we're going to bring in some more lights and stuff like that, and that is about it. As you see, I've named it Time-Lapse Ad Vio, because otherwise I'll forget. So, lots more to do still, lots more lighting and signs, and we're going to go check it out at night time and stuff like that, and we'll talk a little bit about the future, and I'll see you folks in a second, I guess. Right then, folks, here we go. Let's finish off at Black Rock Park. There's still a couple other things dotted around that I'll do before the tour. Still no lights over here, for example. I don't think I really like these. I think I'm going to go back to lampposts, but I have to figure it out. And like I said, I need to do this little bit over there, but otherwise we are basically done, except for this little doohickey in here. Now, the only thing I've been waiting on, I'll give you a little look, a little tour, because you've only seen it in time-lapse. So we've got our aquarium here. In the middle, we have our solar system on the right-hand side with the very weird Earth and Saturn with his rings kind of a little bit funky. I did add a Pluto because I can't exclude Pluto, okay? It's just not fair. We have our information boards here about our animals. So we've got two here for... This one basically covers both of these animals, the Western Diamondback Rattlesnake and also the Gila Monster. That's right. Gila. And over here we have hairy scorpions. That's right, it's a hairy scorpion, the largest scorpion in North America. This hairy scorpion is so large and aggressive. Oh no, I've spelled and twice. Can I change that? Sometimes they're really hard to click. I'll do. This hairy scorpion is so large and aggressive that it can actually feed on lizard, snakes, and even other scorpions. I was just trying to get the tone of a child-friendly announcement thing. Thankfully, it's not deadly to humans, with a sting only as strong as that of a honeybee. Still. Ouch! At this point, I don't actually know what to say. Maybe lyrics from the song. I was listening to music whilst I was doing my time-lapse, as I always do. It's this song... Anyway, I'm just going to talk about it briefly. By La Dispute, one of my favourite bands. And... He's talking about when he went to school and they were reading like a diary from these parents and their kid going through cancer. And there's a line that says, although his spirits are high, his blood counts on. And it breaks my heart every single time. It's a really good song. You should listen to it. I can't remember what it's called. I See Everything. That's what it's called. Wait, no. Yeah. I See Everything. Check it out. It's a good song. Anyways, moving on. Metal Bear says, don't touch. I needed something for the corner, and I needed a sign to say, don't touch my plant life. So Metal Bear says, don't touch. I wanted it to seem mildly aggressive because it amuses me somewhat. And here we have our plants, our different bushes and stuff like that. As you see, I did swap out for the Gwelda rose bush because it's one of my faves. Couldn't fit the trees in, other than the cypress tree for fairly obvious reasons, but... nice little selection there. And then I've just like made up some rubbish there about ecosystems and stuff like that. I think it's pretty cool. But we're not done, obviously. So one thing we need to do, first of all, is we need to make it nighttime. Because the last thing that needs doing is the whole thing needs lighting. The aquarium in particular, we don't know what this is going to look like. But I think each little blob is going to need its own lighting. I think we'll need some lights over here. And I want to put some lights along this line here. Or in there, maybe. Just lighting up the planets from below as well. So, we need lots and lots of lights. Oh my god, my money. It just disappeared. Let's just buy a tiger. If in doubt, buy a tiger. I said this was going to be a profitable zoo, and then it's... I swear it's when I did the, probably when we did the, animals escaped. Oh. How'd you get over there? Everything's going wrong. Low welfare, right, yeah, did I change these to have good welfare? Nutrition, oh, you just need a keeper. That's okay. Let's get some keepers over here. And, because we're at the end, we're going to hire, and tell you what, just hire a couple new ones, how about that? There we go. Nighttime is hitting the park. It looks really cool at night. Look at that, beautiful. The science center doesn't totally fit in. I kind of regret maybe using the blue. We've kind of gone like really hard in on the blue. The blue has been a big focus. When maybe we should have stuck to like the warmer colors, but I don't know. It's like a sciencey section. I think blue's a pretty cool color for that kind of thing. I'm gonna put those lights down there. And then, yeah, like I said, I don't know what I'm gonna do for this bit. I mean, this probably makes the most sense, right? But I don't think that lights it up enough. I don't know. Maybe a lamppost. I'll have a little think. That's been a problem for a long time. Anyways, so let's check out our science center. Look at it from that. First of all, looks really cool from the outside. Being able to see the planets and stuff through the glass and see the text there and the lights around there. That's awesome. Here we go. Yep, I'm really... I wasn't sure about this blue line around the base of the aquarium, but I think that's going to look really cool. I think that looks... just saying, I'm thrilled with how this looks right now. It's very cool. That looks really cool as well. That the text lights up at night is awesome. We need some lights over here. That one doesn't light up. Interesting. Yeah, see, that's awesome. Yep, that's very cool. And that's pretty cool as well. I do want to get some lights on the planets and some lights in front of the text there. But otherwise, I'm really happy. right, okay, so let's get to work. Let's do it bit by bit. We'll start over here on the left. We just need to light up our plant life somehow. So I'm thinking probably not blue. I think the blue lights are for the cool... No. Blue lights when you're trying to be cool. And we'll use sort of warmer toned lights when we want to showcase things, if that makes sense. So, lights, camera, action. So we're using normal lights here. What are we going to use? Can you put like a panel in? That looks weird. It's hard to light the actual plant. Maybe we should hang like a light down from there, but I'm not sure. Ooh, got to be careful here. I'm not. Yeah, that doesn't hang down low enough. What about my hanging lamps? Love my hanging lamps. Is that going to reach? Yeah, just got to keep rotating around. No, see, that doesn't go far enough. That's not bad. That looks pretty cool, actually. It's quite hard to... Maybe if I put, like, one on each side. So it's kind of... Yeah, hey, that's pretty cool. There you go. And I think that kind of suits the theme. What we might do instead... It's like double up, like so. Rotate that around. This should be even on each side, so this should work in theory. I really should just use a different sign now that I think about it. If I just use the other signs, it'll be fine. Because they light up at night. I do prefer these ones because they've got that kind of rustic black rock look we've been going for. But at the end of the day, this is also the science center, so it can be a little bit sciencey, you know? It can be futuristic and techy. It doesn't have to be... Not everything has to be the same. What about those? Yeah, they're better. Let's go for those. So, just need to write these again. And change the text color. Why would it be default like that? Because that's just... silly. I don't know how else to describe it. It's silly. Okay, so I'm just going to duplicate these along. It's funny, if you do this and then go again, I bet the text disappears. Isn't that weird? I think that's really odd. If you duplicate it, the text disappears unless you duplicate it more than once. So look, right, if I do that again, it'll disappear. Okay. Let's rename this one. I always want to read T there. But if we duplicate these, I bet the text stays both times. So duplicate again. Duplicate again. Text stays. Just a weird little interaction that I noticed when I was doing the thing before. I actually prefer these signs. This was a good idea. And they're light and pretty. White sage bush. And finally, the diamond leaf willow bush. Okay, just need to get rid of these ones, shove those ones up a little bit onto the right spot, and we are done with our plants. I love lights. Lights are the best. Meep. I really like that. I am a sucker for lights, though. I mean, more than anything, I'm a sucker for lights, but I just think that looks really cool. Okay, we need a little bit of light over here. My burr needs some love. Don't we all? Don't we all? That just looks like I'm highlighting his penis. Or lack thereof. I'm just like mocking him for his lack of penis. You're just mean. You shouldn't do that to a metal bear. What if I put the light thing on, but I put it if I just hide it behind the sign? No. I wanna light like the front of the sign, essentially. I think that's okay for that. move it a little bit. Rotate it a little bit. Everything a little bit. Everything a little bit. And I'm going to move it. Nope, not that way. Metal Bear says, don't touch. You would do well to listen to him. I don't know why the Metal Bear's like a horror figure in this scenario, but he is. Does the bear himself need some lights? That's a little fine. Does the bear need some love? Yes. Metal Bear has spoken. He demands sacrifice. Wait, I put the eyes in the wrong place. Are they the smallest ones? Metal Bear has spoken. Go further in, you numpty. That better? That's better. Why have you moved? What? Now Metal... I forgot. What is going on? And make this work. Metal Bear will have spoken. Metal Bear has spoken! how small a blob can I get? And that's a weird sentence I just said, but roll with me on this one. What are they? They're huge. Metal Bear carries the globe within his calloused paws. Is that really the smallest they go? I want like a tiny circle. Oh, that'll have to do. Right, that's done. I don't think I want to light this up. I think that's okay. I think the floor probably needs some lights as well, but I don't know. I'm going to save the aquarium for last. This is pretty okay. I do want to light up the sun. Because it's, you know, this freaking sun. So, got that. I'm just going to make this yellow. I'm just going to put a few of these in. Just so we know that light is there, basically. So it kind of looks like it's glowing, even if technically it's, you know, not. I mean, technically it is, I suppose. Something like that. I'd like to make, like, a big shiny orb, but unfortunately I don't have access to a big shiny... What is that? What are you? What? That's all that about. I don't have access to a big shiny orb, so that'll have to do. I kind of like the planets like that, you know? I don't think they need lighting. This, like, backlight effect to them is pretty awesome with the stars. All I need to do is light up this solar system bit down here. And since we've got a theme going already... Oh, use these. Which are in slightly the wrong position. Are they? A little bit to the left, and then a little bit around that way. It's important, okay? Hello there. I don't know if these are the ones I want, but we'll see. Yeah, they're pretty cool. Okay, meow. Should only need one per word. In case you missed it, by the way, these are, they're not just floating, they do have poles behind them, keeping them there. I might double up on the bigger ones. Yeah, that probably makes me, oopsie daisy. I realise it was in a group. Put that one there, and then duplicate that and move that one over there, like so. That's slightly better. Yeah. Yeah. There we go. Cool, yeah, I'm happy with the solar system. Happy with that. Does that need any lights? No, because I want the text to kind of stand out. The bear is terrifying and lit up. That wall might need something. I'm not sure. Path definitely needs some lights. Anyways, right, aquarium time. It's already really lit up just because of the bars around the outside, so I don't want to go too nuts here. I do want to bring in some more colours. I don't want it to just be blue. I was thinking like some purples and yellows and just get a little bit funky with it because I'm a funky kind of guy, what can I say? Yeah, those are like perfect. I just want it to look fun. That's what we're aiming for here, fun. Let's grab another one. Can I turn off the line? Yeah. Get that again. It's not super bright either, which I like. Let's make that one yellow. There we go. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Maybe some more blue in here somewhere. You need to be able to see the jellyfish at the end of the day, right? That's more like it. And I want you to be able to see the lights. They're not, it's not some magical thing, it's a real thing. I think that might too. I'm kind of happy with that. I think that's awesome. Okay. God, I hope this works. I've put a lot of stuff in, so it's making me worried that the water filling isn't going to work anymore. Let's bring the glass up. Please work, please. I have not tried this. How high do I want this to be? We had a little discussion about this. I think I want it below the lights, so probably around there. Oh, I don't know. I'm also tempted to put the blue on top as well, but we'll see. Wish me luck, folks. This is it. The big moment. That was a little... Oh! Is that the size we're going to get? Yeah, that might be because of the lights. That's okay. I just need to move... Oh, the jellyfish are fine. Yeah, there we go. Got myself a little aquarium. A little jellyfish. Some of them chilling at the top, but... I'm going to bring... Oops. I don't know what's going on here. I'd like to bring... this down as far as it can go, like towards the water level. It's not gonna let me do that, is it? I can't put it anywhere. That's the only place it's allowed to be. But maybe I can get rid of the water. I actually prefer it by the water, but it needs the water, otherwise it's nonsense. I'm gonna just try to bring it down a little bit, to like there, and then try again. Yeah, nice. Reckon we can bring it down further? Might as well try, I suppose. Right, so what are we on at the moment? We're on 5.3. Keep that in mind, folks. I'm gonna go down to 5.2. Now that's one step too far, I think. Yes. Okay, so we can raise it up. Ooh, raise me. Nope. Up to. Oh, God. You know, the volumetric water is awesome, but it does make things a little bit more difficult at times. Let's go 5.2 then. You gonna work? Nice. I think that's probably about the lowest it's gonna go. I wanna see. There's a. I'm gonna hit play. Let's see if this works. You can't really see it from the outside, can you? You see it from the inside. Yeah, from the inside you can see. Look at it! Look, look, look! There's like little fish! That's a really cool idea. I cannot. I'm so sorry, I can't remember who told me about this idea, but the idea was to use the blossom petal thingamajiggy in there, because it kind of looks like fish swimming around. Unfortunately, you can't really see it from the outside. Oh, yeah, you sort of got it. It does, it looks like fish. That's really cool. It's very subtle, I like that. I think it needs a roof. I don't know if that's nuts. I'm going to just try it. It should be easy, because this should be in a group. So I should be able to just grab these on their own. Yeah, just duplicate that. Shuffle up there. Yeah, I like that. It's like some weird scientific futuristic aquarium. I'm really happy with this building. I don't know if that's clear or not. Look at that. That's baller. Okay, right. So, all we need to do is light up the path itself. Oh, excuse me. And we should be done. I'm just going to grab the lights we've been using outside and see if they work for this. I think we'll just sort of stick them in the middle. I actually wish I'd gone for a completely different set of lights from the start, but I've kind of committed to them now as an idea. Also, maybe I want to do something in this water, but I'm not sure what. I'm thinking just in the middle. The idea being, you know, like... I don't know, just like a path to follow. I don't know if this is going to ruin the ambience. The ambience. I'm going to keep these nicely spread out, actually. One more in the middle. It's basically perfect. But I think, I don't know, is it too dark? Will people die? I think it's okay. I'm just a little worried people bump into each other and stuff like that. I know that's daft because it's a video game, but the point is we're trying to build something real, right? What if I can put some lights on the roof? Where are they? What's going on? Okay, I don't know what the hell they're doing. I really don't. I don't think you're going to be able to see this light effect, but we can try. For God's sake, come here. Being immensely difficult right here, little light. Nope. A little too far, there we go. Up. Oop. Oop. No, you're not going to see. I want it like this bit. Like, I want that amount of light. I don't really see any way to do it. Oh my god, go away! let's see if there's anything else. I mean, this area lights are bigger. Nope, that's facing them. Hmm. How are these little path lights? They're pretty cool. Yeah, too small. Oh, it is facing the wrong way. Yeah, still too small. Way too small. I mean, it's cute, but it's too small. I'm gonna get there, folks. Lamp. There we go. Lamp post. Beautiful. No. Okay, I'm gonna say it's fine. I think. What we maybe need is like some information panels for the aquarium. Should have boiled. I kind of don't want to ruin it. That's my only. I'm just gonna grab. I'm gonna do what we did over here. Like, we've put these in. There's no info on them at all. But I'm just gonna put a couple of them in. And we can kind of pretend, basically. That is giving information about the jellyfish and the fish and stuff like that. So it looks like there would be information there. Yeah, I'm gonna end it there. That's pretty cool. Right, that is the Blackrock Science Center finished, and that is a pretty awesome looking Blackrock Park. Also finished. Like I said, I've got to do a few more things with the lights, and I might light up some of the other exhibits. This is fine. This whole area needs lights over here. Other than that needing lights, and the little museum, we're officially done. I will get that done before the start of next week. We will come back and we will do a tour video thing. We'll walk around the entire park, see all the different exhibits. I never did finish the staff building, it must be said. The staff building is bare bones. I mean, it's neat and tidy and well made, if I do say so myself. It's just lacking decoration, essentially. But it's a nice building. You can go on this floor as well. You know, it's all very well put together, if I do say so myself. I do have like a little nice canopy area over there overlooking the bison. I don't think I'm going to bother with that, if I'm totally honest, but I'll have a little think about it. Yeah. Oh, Blackrock, I'm going to miss you. Right, anyways, yes, we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for all the suggestions and ideas and stuff. Well, for the past like couple of months or so, we've been working on Blackrock Park, if not more. I think this was like November it started. So, yeah, it's been a long time, so thank you for all the comments and stuff for that. Like I said, there will be one more episode. I will have a few extra things done in the meantime. Until then, thank you so much for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.